In this video, I'm going to talk about how to choose the right bike for you to buy. Now, let's start off with this, TLDR. If you don't want to watch this whole video, go to your local bike shop and get a mountain bike from last year that's on sale. That's the best deal. People get really confused about which bike to buy, mainly because they don't have the requirements clear in their mind. Let me start off by saying this. You're gonna waste money if you buy more bike than you need, and you're gonna waste money if you buy less bike than you need. Let me explain what I mean by that. If you're only gonna bike a mile to school every day, then a $300 bike from Walmart is probably fine. On the other hand, for someone like me who bikes 50 to 200 miles a week up hills, that same $300 bike would be a complete waste of money because I would shred it to pieces in about 2 weeks. Similarly, the bike that's perfect for me is a $3,500 folding bike, very high quality custom made, that goes up hills and can go tens of thousands of miles reliably without a tune-up, is overkill for someone who is going to just ride it a mile to school. So it depends on your use. Don't buy more bike than you need. And don't buy the bike you think you might need tomorrow. Buy the bike you need today. People start thinking, well, what if I race? I'm gonna want a carbon fiber bike. And you know, they end up talking themselves into a $3,000 bike when they don't even know if they're gonna like riding bikes. Buy the bike you need right now. Let's talk about buying used bikes. People all the time are thinking, well, you know, a new bike is $1,000. I can get one for $400 on Craigslist, or, you know, I can order a new one over the internet for $500. What you don't realize about bikes is the purchase price is nothing. Maintenance on bikes is very expensive because bikes are by design lightweight and only strong enough to do the job at hand, which means they need a lot of maintenance, and that's expensive. If you get that $1,000 bike on Craigslist for $500, that's great, but there's a good chance you're gonna have to take it in, get a new chain, get a new cassette, get a tune-up, get the brake cables replaced. Guess what? You're up at $1,000 and you have a used bike instead of a new one. You really have to take maintenance costs into account. Now, if you're very handy and are good at reading instruction manuals and want to do all your own bike maintenance, that's great, but it takes a lot of time. It's worthwhile, but if you don't want to do that, you're not saving money by buying a used bike or a bike over the internet. A used bike is almost never a bargain unless you are a bike mechanic. The best bargain is to go to your bike shop, find the bike you want, and buy last year's model new. The last year's models are typically 15 to 25% discount, and oftentimes a bike shop will give you free tune-ups for a short period. And that makes all the difference in the world in cost, because when you buy a used bike, you have to pay for all that stuff. So factor it all into account when you're trying to decide where to buy your bike. The first decision you'll have to make is mountain bike or road bike. If you don't know, try to find a friend who has both that you can borrow for a while and try. Now, many people think mountain bikes are only if you plan on going off-road. Not at all. I use a road bike only for races. My mountain bikes I use for everyday use because they're much more durable. On roads with potholes, they're indestructible. So they're also more comfortable because they're more upright. If I'm not in a hurry and I'm just getting exercise, I go with my mountain bike. A lot of people make the mistake of thinking that the fastest bike is the best bike. Well, If you're just out for exercise, what difference does it make how fast you're going? Seriously, a one-speed bike could actually be considered better for exercise because you have to work so much harder. So don't use speed as your criteria unless you need to go great distances. A great example of that, say your work is 30 miles away and you want to get rid of your car and bike to work. Yeah, you need a really fast road bike, or you're going to spend your all day on the road biking. So that's a great example of when you need a fast bike. But for most people who are just going to get exercise and have fun, a mountain bike is a much better option because you're more upright and you can look around and enjoy stuff. On a road bike, your head is pointed to the pavement, and that's pretty much all you see. And the pavement in Austria looks pretty much like the pavement in America. Not very interesting. Now, after you've decided what kind of bike you want, road bike or mountain bike, the next thing you're going to be faced with is the bike dealer is going to give you a whole bunch of options that are going to seem really confusing. Let me break it down for you. There's some basic good brands. They're all really good. You know, Trek, Giant, those are all Cannondale. They're all great bikes. You can't go wrong. But when it comes to comparing, it's really difficult. What you need to do is make a list of the components on the bike, because a frame is a frame. It doesn't matter that much. You don't need carbon fiber. The weight is seriously not that important on a bike. Think about it. If you weigh 200 pounds, what's a pound difference on the bike? Nothing. You could lose that in a week of dieting, no problem. If you want to be lighter on your bike, lose weight. Don't spend another $1,000 to get a bike that's a pound lighter. That's silly. So the frame itself is no big deal. What you're really buying is components. The most important to look at when you're comparing bikes is what drivetrain components they have. So for example, you know, two bikes you're comparing both have Shimano. Get down on your hands and knees and see the name on the front and rear derailleurs. It'll be something like Dior or XTR or something like that, depending on whether it's a road or mountain bike. Then go to the Shimano website and look at their rankings. They have about 12 different quality levels of components, and they're listed in order. On mountain bikes, XTR is the highest, and on road bikes, Dura Ace is the highest. So when you're comparing bikes and you're unsure, compare the drivetrain components, and the one with the highest components is a much better deal, because really the frame is just a place to hang expensive components. The components are what you're buying. So I would use that to decide which bike to get. Now I want to cover something really important. Those of you who are over 200 pounds who are buying a bike. The problem with bicycles is, since everyone in the industry seems obsessed with bike weight, they make them as light as possible, which means that often for heavier riders, they will fall apart quickly. It's very difficult to get a bike that's appropriate for someone who is 250 pounds, even if they're going to stay on the road all the time. Because what you'll find is the wheels will quickly fall apart. The spokes will loosen and the wheel will start wobbling and you're toast. So what do you do if you're a heavy rider? I have 3 decades experience with this, so I can tell you. If you're over 200 pounds, I would strongly advise that you get a mountain bike. The reason is, even though mountain bikes are only designed for 180 pound people, they're designed for people of that weight jumping over stumps and going through rough terrain. If you just ride them on pavement, they can hold 250, 300 pounds without a problem. So that's the easiest thing. you're heavy is to get a mountain bike. Now, if you're heavy and really want a road bike to go fast, there's a couple things you need to do. First of all, don't worry about the frame. Any frame is strong enough. Although, I have found that titanium is the best for heavy people because it's very stiff. You won't feel it flexing like a pretzel. But the most important thing with a road bike for a heavy person is the wheels. A normal build-up wheel you will destroy in 2 months, and it gets really expensive fast. There's two things you need to do, or you can do. First of all, is buy one of those aluminum rims that's deep and get the high-tension spokes rather than the traditional round spokes. I found those are very reliable for heavy riders. The other thing you can do is have the bike shop put them tandem wheels, because tandem wheels are designed to hold twice the weight. I actually did that on my Commotion travel bike, and even though I've carried my 220-pound body plus a 40-pound bike plus hundreds and 20 pounds of gear, I have never had a problem with those wheels coming apart. So that's the other option. But if you're a heavy rider, just be warned, it's going to be very difficult to get a bike that will handle your weight reliably. Let's go back and talk about frames a bit. There's traditional old school frames are steel, typically 4130. Aluminum frames are very popular. Also titanium and carbon fiber. Honestly, the frames don't make that much difference in my opinion. It's not worth paying twice as much for a frame that's 3 ounces lighter. And the newfangled carbon frames I hate because a single ding or scratch and they can be destroyed. Steel is indestructible. Aluminum is indestructible. Titanium is indestructible. But the composite frames are very fragile. I would stay away from those. As I mentioned before too, the titanium is nice because it's very stiff. So if you're heavy, that's a good thing. The third thing you need to worry about if you're a heavy rider on a road bike is brakes. If you're a strong rider and are going to be doing hills, when you go down a hill, those rim brakes are not going to do it. Two reasons. First, because of your weight and potential energy, you're going to get those rims so hot, it's going to pop your tires. And when they get hot, they lose braking effectiveness, and you're going to be in trouble. The only way to go with a road bike, if you're over 200 pounds, in my opinion, is to get one that has disc brakes. So let me try to summarize here how to choose a bike. First of all, there is no perfect bike. If there was, I would only own one bike. I have five. The reason is you need different bikes for different purposes. Now, if you just want one bike for general purpose, probably the best thing for you to do is go to your local bike shop where they do their own service and buy a new bike from last year's models at a discount. The reason is that it's important that the bike come serviced with everything new on it, because repair costs can easily be more than the purchase price of the bike if you buy something used or buy something over the internet. The only time buying used or something over the internet makes sense is if you're either a bike mechanic or someone who really likes reading detailed instructions and doesn't mind spending your entire Saturday tuning up your bike and getting it ready to go. And the main rule of buying a bike is buy the bike you need today, not the bike you think you'll need next week or next year. It's a waste of money to buy more bike than you need, and it's a waste of money to buy less bike than you need. I want to talk about the price of bikes. You can get a really good bike for $1,000. Now, a lot of people are going to say, $1,000, that's way too much. But these are the same people who have spent $10,000 to get a reliable used car, pay $1,000 a year insurance, $2,000 a year in gas, and $1,000 a year in maintenance. When you look at the big picture, a bike can be really, really cheap if you can find a way to use it instead of an automobile. Now, I know all people can't do that. Some people can find a way to use the bike for transportation and then use Uber for the times they absolutely need a vehicle and save money. Even if you can't, just using the bike for doing errands can save you a lot of time and frustration in cities where parking is such a big hassle. Just get a bike that has panniers on it so that you can carry your things. So just try to take the big picture in mind when you're thinking about the price of a bike. It's not a toy, it's a transportation vehicle. So I want to show you the bike shed. I have 7 bikes. This first one is a titanium mountain bike. I got this online from bikesdirect.com. It's a Moto Bacan. I absolutely love this bike. It was like half the price of what I'd get at the local bike store. But again, unless you're gonna do your own maintenance, it's not a good deal. This is a Zeppelin by Airborne. This was 20 plus years old. This is also a titanium bike, a road bike. Amazing value. Again, it was purchased through the internet. It would not have been a bargain had I not done my own maintenance. Yet another bike purchased on the internet. Another Moto Bacan. This is a Phantom. This is a, it's got front and rear shocks. Honestly, I think the rear shocks are not worth it. I prefer a hardtail. And another mountain bike. I'm not going to show you the 3 travel bikes I own because they're in suitcases in the attic right now. That's it for today. Thanks for watching, Auf Wiedersehen.